do Christians suffer? I'm sure these questions will have crossed the mind of virtually every child of God. A whole lot of times, individuals, Christians, don't know why they struggle so much. They have prayed, fasted, given their all, at least based on the teachings they have heard, but the struggle continues. You are even tempted to ask, if I don't do something, is this how I will end up? The clock is ticking, I am not getting younger. You move from prayer houses to prayer house, link up from prayer meetings to prayer meetings, but cannot seem to grasp where the problem is. Some name it curses from their mother's or father's house. So there are 10 programs tagged to address this. But year in, year out, it's like the curses are re-energized each time they pray. So they say the curses are so strong and rooted in the curse of Africa. But which curse is so strong that it can overcome the work of salvation? 2 Corinthians 5:17, Amplified Version says, therefore, if anyone is in Christ, that is grafted in, joined to him by faith in him as Savior, he is a new creature, reborn and renewed by the Holy Spirit. The old things, the previous moral or spiritual condition, have passed away. Your new things have come, because spiritual awakening brings a new life. Also, Colossians 2:15 says, the Amplified Version, when he had disarmed the rulers of authorities, those supernatural forces of evil operating against us, he made a public example of them, exhibiting them as captives in his triumphal procession, having triumphed over them through the cross. So you see, there is no legal rule, authority, or spiritual force that can ever stand against us, more so that our sins and iniquities have been thrown to the sea of forgetfulness. You can look at Micah 7:19, Isaiah 43:25, and Hebrews 8:12. God is true to his word, and it will never return to him void. Isaiah 55:11, King James Version says, so shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which I please, and it shall prosper in the things whereto I sent it. The problem is not the cause, brother, because it has been dealt with at salvation. But have you ever asked yourself, on which foundation am I building? So many of us are quick to find solutions to our various challenges without even looking at where the source is from, without considering what we are going into. In 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 10, Berean Literal Bible says, according to the grace of God, having been given to me as a wise master builder, I have laid the foundation, but another is building upon it. But let each one take heed how he built upon it. Many are building on wrong foundations, and because God cannot build on what he has not ordained, so many struggles. Psalm 11 verse 3 says, of course, Berean Study Version also, if the foundations are destroyed, what can the righteous do? Now you need to know the fact that a key element of failure is building on the wrong foundation. If God wants you in the United States and you are in China, you can never get the same result where grace supports. Anything outside grace can only struggle. And if struggle gives you what you currently possess, you cannot imagine what grace has to offer. I heard about the story of Kenneth E. again. At some point, God told the wife, if you do not let this man serve me, I will take him away from you. And you can pause to wonder, why would God say this to the wife of his faithful servant, someone we look up to as a father of faith? But look at this. She sometimes complained her husband was traveling too much, but the call was evangelical. God told him, even as he revealed in one of his visions, how Jesus spoke to him, my people are so selfish, talking about Christians. They say they are ready and talk about their mansion and the glories of heaven, while many all around them are in darkness and have no hope. Say to him, share your hope with them. Invite them to come with you. Going against God's word or plan for your life, more so when you know it, is a deliberate disobedience against God. Yet many fast and pray for God's blessing, even in disobedience. The question, how are you building on your marriage? How are you building on your academics? How are you building on your ministry? How are you building on your finances? What are you exposing your family to? Father, this is heavy on me, but the burden to preach the truth of your word, please do not take away. I cannot do anything outside your grace. Do not let me and everyone you are pouring this grace, the grace to stand even at this end time, depart from your word. Let us be part of the selection of the abundance of grace for your next move and prepare the heart of men for this new wave of your glory the world has never seen before. Glorify Jesus even through your church. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hello there, my name is Udwag Akwan. Thank you so much for watching today's teaching. If this has really blessed you, please do not forget to subscribe and to like and also to share. There could be somebody out there that just needs to also hear what you just listened to. I want to also, by this video, encourage you to become the journalist of your life, taking note of some things the Holy Spirit might want to impute into your spirit. God wants to start with a new generation it can depend on. God depends on us to pass the message of hope around. Of course, you know there are so many deteriorating messages going on around, but God needs you as the salt of the earth and the light of the world to pass the message of hope and let people know what He can actually do in this time and dispensation. And that is where God so much depends on you. Thank you so much. See you another time. God bless you real good. Don't forget, the name is 𝐅𝐨𝐥𝐼𝐿.